The Ableton Live script for the Sensel Morph adds extensive control over Live from the music overlays. This reduces the need for your mouse and keyboard and limits the amount of MIDI mapping you might need to do in Live itself. We've remapped and repurposed several of the standard buttons in interesting ways to give you more control over Live. As you'd expect, the pads and keys play instruments. The top buttons get some extra attention. The arrow keys are used to change your track and instrument. These keys are used for controlling your send effects on a track. And the transport keys for play, stop, and overdub work without any MIDI mapping. The far right key acts as a momentary shift key. Much like the shift on a computer keyboard, when you hold this down, many of the buttons and pads change what they do. For example, holding shift and pressing a pad will trigger a clip in the session view, or I can move my session view grid using shift and arrow keys. Before you can do any of this, there's a bit of setup involved. You'll need to download our setup files to make sure the overlays have the correct MIDI map, and you'll need to install the script using our installer. Visit our shop and download the free installers for the script. This download has the script, an example set with a great new drum kit, and the overlay maps that program your morph for this setup. Once you've downloaded the maps, just open the Sensel app and select Import Map from the menu and select one of the Ableton maps for the morph. Do this for each music overlay. If you want to adapt another overlay or custom design for the script, you can easily do this since each function is correlated with a single MIDI note. Now that your morph is flashed with the right maps, let's set up Ableton Live. In Ableton Live, we'll need to go to the Preferences, where we will load the script. Select the MIDI tab, then select the Sensel Morph from a Control Surface menu, and select the morph for the input and output. Below that, you'll want to enable the morph for track and remote for MIDI input. Now I'm ready to show off some of the amazing features of this script. This script works with all music overlays. I can easily select a track with the arrow buttons, and the track will automatically arm, meaning I can play it instantly with the morph. This works on any of the overlays. I can also use the arrows and the shift key to move the session box left and right, then use the pads to trigger a clip using the shift key. The 4x4 grid of the music production overlay corresponds to the 4x4 grid that is highlighted in Live. These button icons look like effects, so we made them control the sends using pressure. Just press down to add reverb or whatever you have in the return. Hold down shift, then lift your finger from the send button to set the send at a fixed value. These, of course, play the set or stop it. The record button maps to overdub. Now that overdub is enabled, I can use the shift key to launch a clip and overdub some playing into the clip. While the music production overlay has the most obvious grid, we can use shift to trigger clips with the drum and piano overlays too. In this track, I'm using the wavetable synth, which makes it easy to apply aftertouch and pitch bend to parameters. Let's take a listen to what we can do with some more expressive play. The music production overlay has a couple other tricks. When using a drum rack, we can easily transpose up and down to different cells in the drum kit while making the new pads visible in Live. You can do this with the shift and these two small keys next to the grid. If you want to transpose the small keys, use shift and the far right keys. It's also possible to split the small keys and pads on the music production overlay. Just assign your tracks different MIDI channels and arm the tracks manually. The knobs and sliders have some great functions too. The knobs automatically map to the device with the blue hand for instant effects control on your track. To get the most out of this, you'll want to make sure you group your instruments so they have 8 macros up front. You'll see that on a device with no macros, like this wavetable synth, the knobs map to the first 8 parameters that Live finds for the device. You may get unintentional results. If you hold down shift, these knobs and sliders are all user mappable to fix parameters for additional control over your set. For example, I can map these to control the volumes on the first 8 tracks. With this script, you should be able to really go deep with the Sensel Morph. By concentrating a lot of control without a lot of complexity, you'll be laying out tracks anywhere, anytime, but not compromising on quality.